So that's good. Now, the next thing we need to look at is the Bluetooth to get that working. And what we need to do is to edit make.conf again. And we need to add in Bluetooth to the use flags. So enable that globally. And then we need to emerge a package called blues, minus AV, so we can store it in the world package. Help if I spelt it correctly. Blue with a Z on the end. Okay, so there's a few options there a few packages to install. Now there is a deprecated option here. This one here, which if you enable that, will allow an extra tool called HCI config. So if that's something you want, you might want to add that into the packages.use. So I'm going to add that in. And it's net wireless blues, net wireless blues. So net wireless blues, and is it deprecated, wasn't it? So just add that in there, and this is one of the reasons why I like Vi. That would all be color coded and easier to read, but there you go. This is oops, what's happened there? Cancel. Save modified battery, yes. Oh, it wants to know the file name, even though I've already told it. Okay, stroke S, etc, portage, package dot use. Right. Okay, this is me not knowing how to use Nano. Do I save this again? Is it Control X? Save buffer, yes. So will that have created that file? Oh, I see. It's because there's a directory there. They default some of these to directories, so I'm going to get rid of them because I don't use the directories. I'm just going to use straightforward files. So portage package.mask and package.use. And now retry. So it was net wireless. Oh, now we've got some colors, that's better. Blues deprecated. So we have got some colors, so that's good. Save that, yes. Right, that's much better. So now if I recall the emerge blues, that flag should now be in red, showing that it will be activated when, there it is, when blues is installed. So I'm going to install these packages now. Not sure how long this will take, I guess a few minutes. And this will be the first stage in indicating whether the Bluetooth has been enabled. So there's one kernel command that's come up there. It's kernel option, sorry. Key DH operations. Key, I'll make a note of that. DH operations. So we'll have to ensure that is enabled in the kernel before we carry on. And that message should come up right at the very end. Anyway. Okay, so that's Blues, that's now installed. Took a little while, I think, because CMake was in there, I saw. Just look at the messages there, see if there's anything to do. There is that kernel modification we've got to do up here. And looks like the only thing I have to do is to add Bluetooth to the startup. I don't think it actually says that there. Which should activate it normally. Pass the update, add Bluetooth default. So that's just start up. We do need to configure the kernel next. And it's config key DH operations that needs to be enabled. So let's go to the source directory of the kernel, make menu config. So I'll search for that pressing forward slash key underscore DH underscore operations. There it is there, yes, it's set to no. So if I press 1, press the space key to enable it, then I can exit, save the changes, and then I'll have to run the command to build the kernel. So I'll just recall it. That's that one there. Hopefully this won't reboot. In fact, thinking about it, may build quite a lot of the kernel, rebuild quite a lot of the kernel, but we'll see. Hopefully it will just touch on a few parts of the kernel and it'll be a quick build. So it does indeed look like it might just be a small part of the kernel that's going to be built. Yep, that's all it is. It's just finishing off now. Okay, so now we need to copy the new kernel into boot. Let's check that boot is mounted. Oops. Okay, and we copy from Arch ARM64 boot. We should have a new image there. Copy it to boot and we'll overwrite the old kernel8.image. And finally we need to do make modules install in case there are any new modules created or even updated, so just wait for that to finish. Okay, so now the next thing I need to do is to reboot to have that kernel take effect. Okay, so I've got the prompt back again. Login. Now if I do uname minus a, you'll see that the kernel has got hash 2 here, which means it's the like a second build because we've made some changes. So that is a good thing. Right, what I need to do, let me just check my notes. Right, what we can do now is to run the Bluetooth command. Bluetooth CTL, and I think we'll do list. You can see there's no adapters there, so that shows that we need to still do some more work. And what we need to do here is to once again plug in the SD card and mount the root file system. So I'll put it on mount, and we need to copy from the root the SD card a file from lib firmware again, BRCM, and this time the name of the file is BCM4345C5.hcd, and once again we copy that into our own lib firmware BRCM, and that should be that. So if I now unmount the SD card and unplug it, I should be okay to do a reboot, and that should in theory be enough to get the Bluetooth working. Okay, so it's just booting up now. Oh, for some reason the NTP failed to start. Maybe the network lead I've got plugged in. It's broken. The tab is broken, so it could be a problem. So I can start it manually. I should fix it. Yeah, the cable's just hanging out a little bit. Okay, so now if I do Bluetooth control and do list, okay, it's not working. Right, I've just noticed, I wonder if that's what it is. I've left there's something you've got to put in the configuration file, so let's mount boot I've forgotten to put in, there's a command you got to put in to turn on the Bluetooth. So I'm just going to put it underneath here. And it is DT param equals KRNBT equals on. I'll save that and let's do a reboot and try that again. Okay, so log in again. Let's just look at this mod. Yeah, that's looking good. Bluetooth control. Yeah, it's actually saying it's got a controller there now. And yeah, that's obviously the list command is what happens when you start. Bluetooth can do the show on, will show. I'll try to turn it on. I've forgotten how to use this. Is it discoverable? No. Power on, maybe. Succeeded. Now let's try show on. Controller not available. Not sure what that means. Maybe there's some more software to install. When I was getting the Bluetooth working, I did have KDE installed because I wanted to see whether that changed behavior, and it certainly did. As soon as I got this Bluetooth working as you see it now, that all seemed to work. So it could be for just the command line that there are more options. Or more packages to install. Scan. Just a list again. It's definitely there, isn't it? Yeah. No, I'm not quite sure how to drive this, but it's certainly there. You can see it's got an IP address. It's coming up. There is another command we can do, which is the, if you remember I said if you build blues with the deprecated flag, you'll get this HCI config command. And if you do HCI config minus A, you can see there's all the network details about the Bluetooth there. So you can see the hardware is definitely working. Unfortunately, the message doesn't really show much to indicate whether the Bluetooth is working or not. If I put this through grep. Beg your pardon. Yeah, you get these HCI messages here when the hardware is working. These messages here and I don't think you get these BNET messages either. When previously, when I was trying to get this to work before I'd got the driver installed, and possibly before that config.txt command that I just put in, the dtparam kernbt equals on, these lines here are the only lines that were appearing in the message. So these are the ones that you should see when the Bluetooth is fully functional. Although, like I say, I don't know how to drive the Bluetooth properly from the command line. I'm happy that this looks identical to what I saw when I was testing with KDE. You can see things like frequencies there and so on. So it is definitely working. There's no doubt about that.